Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Jenny Trott. Today's film is for anyone who has a caring role as part of their life and includes some free printables, so stay tuned. If you're anything like me, you don't really want to spend a huge amount of time thinking about what might happen if you're not there for the person that you care for. We might not like to think about it, but think about it we should, because there's a few things that we can do just to deal with that emergency situation and make it a little bit easier for the person that we care for and the people that might be required to step in our place, even if it's just for a few hours. So I've got a few printables that I've lined up, one which I've found from another agency, and a couple of things that I've created myself, which I think might be helpful. And I'll tell you how to download those at the end of the film. But first, I'm going to explain what they all are. The first printable is an emergency planning document, which has a lot of thought has been put into this, not by me, I have to say. It's something that I found online that a charity has produced. And so it's an emergency planning form that you can either download onto your computer and fill in on screen, or you can print it out. There's a couple of different formats that you can download it in, print it out and fill it in by hand. And it prompts you to fill in everything from the person's name and date of birth all the way through to what they like to eat, how they like to eat it, how they communicate, where their medicines are kept. A lot of really useful information is asked for. And I sort of see that as a, for the first 48 hours, what does somebody need or group of people need to keep the person that you care for safe and relatively happy and fed and medicated, everything that they would normally need as part of their day-to-day life. That form also asks you to list emergency contacts, and so you want to have a chat to the people who you're going to list on there just so that they know what's being asked of them. And this form actually asks you to get them to sign it, to say that they've read it, which is a bit of a faff. I'm just in the process of doing that myself, trying to track everybody down and get them to sign the form and read it to say they've understood. Heaven forbid it would ever be needed, but we're doing it just in case, and so it's important those people know what's expected of them. The next two things I want to offer you are printables that I've created myself. The first one was inspired by something that I saw in another part of the country. In fact, East Sussex have a scheme whereby you can register with your local authority as a carer, and they will add you to a database system, give you a card which has got your details on, and it says, I'm a carer, if required, call this central number within the local authority, and they hold a list of all your emergency contacts, and they kind of direct those first responders or whoever has called them that you care for someone who might be at home waiting for you, and they call in your emergency contacts. That clearly requires a setup, an organisation, which East Sussex has very cleverly done. I don't think there's many places in the country that do that. If you live in one of those places and you know it does exist, put a comment down below so that other people in your area can also look that out. But if you live somewhere like we do up here in North Ayrshire, and the local authority hasn't organised something like that, then I would suggest you do it yourself. And that is why I've created these cards for you. And what you do is you can print off these cards off your own printer, fill in your details, and then either laminate them, or you could cover them in sellotape just to make them a little bit longer lasting. And these cards say, attention, I'm a carer, someone depends on me. If you suddenly fall ill, or you're in an accident and a first responder, a paramedic or a police officer is looking for ID and is checking your purse or your wallet or even the dash of your car, you could have several of these in different places. And it very clearly shows them that you are a carer and that someone depends on you. So on the back, it lists your emergency contacts, and it also says what your name is and the person that you care for, because I thought, well, if somebody finds that and they phone one of your emergency contacts, they can then say to them, hi, I've just come across Jenny, she's been in an accident or she's unwell. I understand that you are an emergency contact for her son, James, because somebody might be an emergency contact for more than one person. So it immediately makes it clear whose plan they're being called into to help with. So the idea is that you would keep that in your purse or wallet, and then if you were in an accident or fell ill, it sets a process in motion to make sure that the person that you care for is going to be attended to. Following on from that, the next card I've created is for your emergency contacts. So let's say you're an emergency contact and somebody calls you up and says, Jenny's been in an accident. I understand that you're an emergency contact for her son, James. That person can then get out their emergency contact card. On the back, it tells them who this emergency is relating to, because again, they might be an emergency contact for more than one person. So it tells them who this is relating to. It tells them where the emergency plan is kept, and really that should be in more than one place. And a quick tip there, when I first did mine, I thought, well, we'll keep a copy of the emergency plan at the school and I'll let social work keep a copy of the emergency plan. And then as I was writing my cards out, I suddenly thought, well, both of those places are office hours only. So what happens if something happens to me at night or during the weekend? So what I decided to do was I'll keep an emergency copy of the emergency plan with the first person on my emergency contacts list, so that hopefully that person, one of those three sources, would be there to activate the emergency plan. So it tells you where the emergency plans are kept, and it also lists the place where, or the person who has your key to whoever's house is appropriate. So for me, my son is still living at home, so it would be whoever has the key for the house to be able to let themselves in and either attend to my son or let him in when he comes home from school and access all his medication and everything like that. So it lists who's the key holder. So you would print those out, you would fill them in, you would laminate them or cover them in sellotape to keep them nice and clean and fresh, and then you would give those to the people who are your emergency contacts on your emergency plan. So just to recap, we've covered actually creating an emergency plan, and that form was created by a charity called Enable, and you'll find the link to that below this film. Then the two cards that I'm going to suggest you print out and complete and distribute. The first one is the I'm a carer, I look after someone, you need to do something about that card, which you yourself as a carer would keep in your purse or wallet. And the second card is for you to print out, complete, and then give to your emergency contacts, the people who will be phoned up and asked to come and help in an emergency. And those are all on my website. And the link again is below the film, but that is www.jennytrott.co.uk. So that's fairly easy to remember. And when you go onto that website, if you just go follow the links to downloads, and you'll see you can just click on the PDFs and they'll open straight up for you. You can either download them or you can just print them direct from the website. So let me know if you think those are helpful. Download them. If you come across any issues, let me know. Put your comments down below and let me know if those are helpful for you. Thanks for watching. If you have a caring role as part of your life, you'll know that finding reliable information can be quite tricky, and that's what this channel is all about. I release new films every week about all sorts of subjects relating to being a carer for young and old. So why not subscribe? It's free. Just follow the link there with my picture on it, and it'll take you to subscribe to my channel, and that means that you'll get notified every time there's a new film to watch, and I'd really appreciate that.